Welcome to AP Environmental Science. In this video, we are going to briefly discuss some of the human impacts on wetland and mangrove ecosystems. Remember, wetlands are areas or ecosystems that have most of the land covered with water for either all of the year or part of the year. And some of the categories that we have discussed in this course, particularly in the earlier units, included bogs, mangroves, marshes, and swamps. Now, mangroves are a special type of wetland ecosystem, and these are made of salt-tolerant trees that grow along the shorelines of the intertidal zone, so the area between high tide and low tide. Now, these provide a huge amount of ecosystem services, particularly the service of shoreline stabilization. And these can absorb 4 times as much carbon dioxide as an upland forest. So they're really important to maintain and preserve. Some of the ecosystem services, which remember there are 4 categories of, include providing a drinking water source for humans as a provisioning service. A regulating service would be flood protection. Remember, wetlands absorb a huge amount of water during rain events and then slowly release that back into the environment downstream. So that protects the homes downstream from experiencing large flood events. Another regulating service would be water purification and filtration, which again serves as a drinking water source, which is the provisioning service. Cultural services include providing ecotourism opportunities. There is a huge amount of bird and amphibian species that live exclusively in wetland ecosystems, and a lot of people like to go and hike in wetlands or near wetlands to observe this incredible amount of biodiversity. Supporting services also include that habitat for the organisms to live in, along with the oxygen from the photosynthesis of all of the wetland plants, and the nutrient cycling that takes place. Now, wetlands are under attack, and some of the major threats include commercial development, dam construction, overfishing, and pollution from agricultural and industrial waste. But before we get into those 4, I want to talk about another threat to wetlands, which is the draining of wetlands. Throughout much of the upper Midwest, the wetlands have been drained in favor of turning that land into productive agricultural land. And the way that they do that is by putting these pipes underground. And so that water takes the path of least resistance and will travel through the soil into those pipes and then through the pipes out into drainage ditches or waterways. And this has completely changed that landscape of the upper Midwest. In terms of commercial development, oftentimes wetlands are actually filled in to provide a location for building roads and parking lots or placing in utilities. And this construction exposes the soil, and that can lead to sedimentation, and that sedimentation destroys habitat, and this construction redirects water flow. Now, the Wetlands Protection and Restoration Act in the United States regulates the development in and around wetlands. This is not one of the pieces of legislation that you need to know for the AP exam, but I think it's important to bring up that there is a level of regulation that takes place. Now, in this picture, you can see a silt fence along a construction site, and that is helping to reduce that sedimentation into the waterway to reduce the impact on that ecosystem. Dams also impact wetlands, and oftentimes dams are built along rivers. So how does that impact the wetland? Well, the dam is going to redirect that water flow, and instead of that water flowing down into these wetland basins, it's going to be caught above the dam, and then it will be a narrow channel below that dam. So we're restricting that water flow. This is also going to disconnect that river from the floodplain, and the floodplain is often where those wetlands are located. Additionally, dam construction prevents sediments from moving downstream. And oftentimes those sediments are bringing the natural and beneficial nutrients from the upstream areas down to that wetland to promote that natural cycling in that wetland ecosystem. Finally, these dams are going to impact the migration of fish and other species that normally move up and down that riverway. Overfishing can also impact wetlands. So when a commercial fishing operation is trying to harvest fish, or even if there are too many recreational fishermen in a specific area, we can catch fish faster than they can naturally reproduce and replenish the population. Now, this is going to alter the size and age and type of fish that are found in an ecosystem, and that can create a cascading impact on the rest of the ecosystem through what's called a trophic cascade. Finally, pollution can impact wetlands, and this can be in the form of nutrient pollution, so that nutrient runoff from agriculture, which leads to eutrophication. This can also be in the form of chemical pollution from things such as industry, and those chemicals could poison the organisms living in that wetland. Now, in summary, remember that wetlands and mangroves provide a vast variety of ecosystem services, and humans can actively damage these wetland ecosystems through their actions, such as commercial development, dam construction, overfishing, and agricultural and industrial waste. Please send me your questions here at the end, and I hope that as you watch this video, you were able to learn something.